Ladies and gentlemen, hello, it's 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. This is Anthony John Agnello, Joystick Community Manager, and it is time for Joystick Streams. And let me ask you a question, everybody. Do you know things about ponchos? Because I know things about ponchos. I know that they make very lovely dog beds when you worn them out, and I know that they're incredibly comfortable to wear when you're standing outside of a Fish concert in 1996. Making a grilled cheese sandwich.
What is even happening right now?
and they go really well with Martha Stewart.
Really good with Martha Stewart. But there are many secrets about ponchos and secret ponchos that I don't know anything about.
I mean, are these secretive ponchos, like they keep secrets, or they're when someone opens a box and they're like, surprise, there's a poncho in here. It's a secret poncho.
I'm not the expert. These are secrets about ponchos and secretive ponchos that I don't know. And that's why Joystick is hanging out with none other than Switchblade Monkeys. And we have Yusuf Mapara of Switchblade Monkeys here with us to show us the ins and outs of the new, accessible for the first time here, 4v4 player mode of their PC and PlayStation 4 game Secret Ponchos. Hello, Yusuf.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm very well. We're slowly but surely trying to get the entire Joystick crew running the game. We have a veritable drunken posse of Joystickers today. You heard Ludwig Kitzman having an existential crisis about what kind of ponchos we're dealing with. Hello, Ludwig.
Hi, how's it going?
Really well. We have Jessica Lynn Condit, who is sitting in an incredibly uncomfortable chair to play this game.
Yes, I am. Hello.
We have, hanging out with us, but unfortunately not able to be playing the game at the moment, Mr. Zav D'Amatos.
Hey, everyone.
And Alexander Sliwinski himself, who is currently installing the game. So
No. I am installed. I am trying to figure.
He's ready.
Am I ready, Luddy?
Well, you have to make a character.
I've done
you
that. His album. Name is El Scalato.
All right. I went with Drew often.
I'm Xenophilius.
So
obviously.
I picked Josie Wales, but no one gets to see that now.
Aww.
And you can go into your outlaw stream. So the wanted rank goes up the more you play, the better you play, I assume.
Yeah, like
and it's reflected in
terms of a number. Basically, you make an outlaw, and there's a bounty on your head, and all the other players have a bounty on their head. And if you fight them, if you beat them, your bounty goes up, and their bounty goes down. So you want to be the person on the head, the game with the biggest price on your head. If you, as you kind of level up, you'll see your reputation kind of increase as your head goes up. So everyone starts out as a petty criminal, and then you kind of work your way up to like a bandit, an outlaw, and as you do that, you kind of get perk points that you can upgrade your character with.
Cool. I'm excited to see any extra skins for each of the characters. I love that stuff.
Oh yeah, there's so much fun. Like even the first set of designs was so cool to make, like, you know, the first Kid Red design and stuff, and it's really fun doing a different take on it.
Very cool.
Alright, so are we happy with our audio and video? We can start shooting.
Yeah! I think we can absolutely do that.
Alright, so should I invite you guys, or should we, you guys...
I think I can invite people. I mean, does that make the most sense if I host this one?
It'll probably make more sense for me because I got all our Switchblade Monkeys guys on here. So let me just make sure we got all. I can see all you guys. So did Robo Kitty?
That's me.
Yeah, and did you get receive my invite or my friend request?
I don't see one.
Okay. Maybe on the Steam level, see if you got a friend request. I can send you another one.
Yeah, I saw Bloodies and...
Okay, let me see again.
Sorry, yeah.
Hey, Luddy, while we're trying to figure this out, why don't you show people the creation of your outlaw, like the different classes that people could select? Can we go through that a little bit, maybe?
Yeah, let's see that. Jump into outlaw, and... create a new outlaw pretty easily. looks like they change in terms of the primary weapon and the secondary weapon, and then they also have different attributes, as you can see: damage, fire rate, stamina, range, speed, health, and difficulty. Now, is that difficulty in terms of mastering them?
Yeah, it's actually like some they're all kind of balanced. If you get really good at them, a good player will be, they're all kind of equal, but some of them are really hard to pick up, you know, so we just added the difficulty for that. So like Deserter, for example, everyone thinks he sucks. He's like Zangief. Everyone has trouble with him when they first start, and they're like, oh, this guy's horrible. But then if you get good with him, there's some really good Zangief players in Street Fighter, for example.
We've got Kid Red, who I'm playing. I liked him because he has two pistols, dual pistols, dynamite as a secondary weapon. Really, I think he's the fastest character that's available right now, but he has really low health, and his damage is kind of low, too.
Folks, before we go any further, some of you may have noticed in the title of today's stream that we are doling out free codes for Secret Ponchos here on Steam. And keep an eye out. Those codes will be appearing in the chat. Mr. Zav D'Amatos is in control of our master list of delightful little ways to get in on the early access version
of this.
I just
put them all in right now, so we're good.
Just all at once! No. Taken care of! And if you don't know, it's very easy to redeem a Steam key when you have it. In the Steam client, there's a little thing right at the top. You go down to games, it says activate a product. You'll be taken to a screen where you plug it in. You just copy and paste. It's very simple. But yeah. And then you can join us, and you can be a creepy old man like Ludwig's character, or a skull man like my character.
Well, the Phantom Poncho, he's actually wearing a poncho.
Actually, you...
So I feel like that alone should give you a significant...
Yusuf, you were doing a little talking about Street Fighter there for a second.
Yeah.
Is the Phantom Poncho secretly Skullomania from Street Fighter EX?
Because he's secretly Skeletor.
Yeah. Oh man, no, we don't have Sam Prell from Joystick to just inundate us with Skeletor imitations.
I'm okay with that.
Doll Parts APB in the chat is just like, it's not a skull man.
Is, Jess, did you receive my friend invite?
Oh yeah, we're totally friends now. I see
okay,
it.
Okay, sweet. I'm gonna...
Yeah.
I don't have a friend invite.
Get out.
Unless, Yusuf, you're NL Crocolis?
No.
Okay,
no.
So that's
I'm
not you.
I'm Switchblade Monkeys.
That is a very silly name that you just said, Alexander. That is
well,
my
that's,
new
Well, that's
favorite.
What I have. Oh, sorry. It's Slyzander with a space.
All right, so I'm missing two of you. I got, is it okay to say this? The
yeah, one? Go right ahead.
Okay, I got Screwjack.
That's me.
And I got, let's see. C and the Bells, are you in my lobby?
I am not in your lobby, and how do I...
I'll invite you again. There you go.
There it is. There it is.
And Drew Afternoon, what was yours again?
Which one?
Luddies.
I'm Mr. Ganucci.
Oh, okay. Yes, I see you.
Mike right. Susick of Joystick has just asked in the chat, how secret are these ponchos? Mike, they're the secretest.
It's funny, our name, everybody, they either they love it or they hate it. They're like, that's the stupidest name. Why do you call your
name? I love it. Yusuf, remind me, the first time that you guys announced that you were going to be on PlayStation 4 was at E3 2013, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, during the grand press conference, mic drop moment of that day. And I remember
know,
when they were...
So crazy.
It was nuts.
The press conference.
I remember sitting there when they were going through the litany of independent studios that were going to be bringing their games to PlayStation 4, and when they were like, Secret Ponchos! I was like, I have no idea what that is. I automatically want to know what that
mm-hmm.
is.
It's good.
That's awesome, I'm glad. That was so scary. Funny, Chris, our music guy, he was with me, and I was really nervous, and you have to stand up, right? And he's like, no matter what you do, don't hold the controller at your crotch level. And that seems to be... That seems to be the natural thing to do when you're standing and playing video games.
It really is! Oh man! I never thought about how awkward that might look when you're on stage, but...
I feel really self-conscious now. I'm going to play like this, just so I'm 100%
Ludwig,
sure.
Hold that controller right up by
and
your
the
cheek.
The controller is nowhere near my crotch.
Okay, so I got Bograt, Faye, and Drew Afternoon in the match. Is anyone else... someone need... Oops.
I'm not in a match. I'm just hanging out.
Are you in the lobby?
I am. I don't Jess? See anyone.
See, this music just makes me want to say Quentin Tarantino lines.
Oh, there we
lines.
Go. Okay, it's going to start. We started it, guys. But...
All right, we are finally underway. And this is a full-on joystick versus...
I'm not in it. No.
All I see is other characters' names. I think I'm with Ludwig.
I think it's pairing you with people who are just playing
with
the
randoms.
Game right now.
Right. All right. I think I might have accidentally started it with a gap in there. And
that's
so,
fine. Just go ahead.
Okay. Yeah, have fun.
I'm just going to be lonely.
Alexander, we can play a game.
We can be lonely together.
I guess.
Would you like to play a game?
Aww. All right.
I feel like now is a great time to learn how to play.
Yes, right. Yusuf, I have no idea what I'm doing at all.
Okay, so stick with the blue guys. They're on your team. They're your posse. And we got to be careful for those other guys. So if you need to cover by, pressing, L2 on a PS4 controller, you'll hide. You'll disappear from their field of view. But yeah, let's go attack them. Those little red things are off-screen indicators that shows where they are.
Ludwig, B is a really cool dash move for me. I'm not sure if you have the same thing.
Nice. I've been stunned.
Oh, just stunned.
I'm dead. If anybody is wondering, my character's name is Woe-O-O-Fee. Because the last time I wore a poncho was indeed at a Phish concert once upon a time, so that is a bit of bizarre humor for you.
Gets a kill, the little skull moves one to our side, and every time their gang gets a kill, it moves to their side. So the first team to get it all the way over wins.
Oh, I just whipped a guy in the face! Alright. I didn't realize that I could, Simon Belmont people.
So, boom! You guys know how to, aim and shoot and everything?
Got the aiming down, I've got the shooting down. So I'm not sure. Is the evasive roll, part of the craft?
No, if you press, are you on a controller? A PS4?
I'm on an Xbox.
So, what is that? What's the farthest one on the right?
It is the B button.
Okay,
so what's the B button to evade?
And that costs a stamina unit, and that's in the bottom. You'll see underneath your health bar, you'll see stamina.
Oh, I got
that down. Regenerates over time?
Yeah, it regenerates if you stand still, and if you take cover, it regenerates even faster. Cool.
Wow, whoever are backing me and Ludwig up on the movie, I am greatly appreciated.
Alright,
Ludwig, you gotta reload.
Oh yeah, you gotta reload, by.
Oh my god, I just killed her own guy.
Reload to reload is X. I am looking at the control cheat sheet.
Okay. Alright, so reload is X. E is roll.
You got the shooting down.
Yeah, and now if you want, you can stop by pressing Y on the Xbox.
Oh, that's the secondary.
Yeah, the secondary weapon. And so now, the same way with the analog stick and throw it. You can cook it in your hand by holding down RT, and then when you let go of RT, you can cook it.
Oh wow.
Or you can, if you're brave, if you're stamina, you can run up to somebody and press RB, and you'll stick it right on the guy's pocket, and then you can run away.
Oh, that's cool.
Cool.
Alright.
Wow, that is very swift, that round.
Yeah, I think,
Now, Yusuf, this is the first time that you guys, today is the day that you guys are bringing out the 4v4 fights, right?
Well, we're bringing out the 4v4 in our update on the 5th, so you guys are the first press to ever get to play the 4v4.
Got it. And so
exclusive world premiere!
Wow! Doritos for everybody. No. So how does the pace of that round that we just played compare to the 2v2? Are the 2v2 a little bit more drawn out? Are
2v2 is like more intimate. Like you're like, what is my teammate thinking? What are they doing? And you follow them carefully, you know. And 4v4, when you don't know what you're doing, you just run around. It's like really chaotic. But when we find that when people get good, then they start thinking more like the 2v2, but it's just faster paced, because if you accidentally step into an enemy team, four guys shooting you will gun you down right away. So it, whereas you have a little bit more durability when you walk into a 2-on-1 situation.
So, yeah. how do you like your choice of redhead?
I like him. I like the speed. He's easy to keep track of because his head is red. I still need to get the hang of taking cover at the right times and reloading.
Yeah, Scullomania here, Scully McScullerson. his shotgun is super powerful, but I haven't gotten quite a feel for the timing yet. There is a strategic element to this. You got to kind of know how like that process of reloading and everything is. But man, the whipping feels good. I enjoy the whipping.
Do we need to regroup in a lobby again?
I want to play. All
right.
Send you guys invites.
Joining.
Yeah, this time I'm gonna make sure I get.
Jess, what is your character's name?
My character's name is Xenophilius.
Xenophilius.
All right, so you're not in the lobby.
Yes, I could invite.
I see that, and then I click it. Let's see.
So you hit shift tab.
Joining lobby. Yes, I got it. Woo! I didn't have the game loaded last time I clicked it, and it didn't take me there. There I am.
Xenophilius.
And I'm missing one of you. Who am I missing?
Yes, Harry Potter nerd.
I know.
Oh, am I back again? You're missing me, Alexander. Sly Xander.
Sly Xander, okay.
Sly Space Xander.
So Sly. Sly. Sly, S-L-I, by the way, right?
Yeah. I dropped it in the Skype a couple times.
Oh, okay. We're not even friends yet.
Alexander.
No.
Alexander.
You think my friendship is cheap?
Alexander, whenever I see your Steam name, I feel like it should be sung by Cab Calloway.
I don't know who that is, Dad.
Yeah, what?
Oh, come on.
Dad jokes.
Cab
Calloway. Yusuf, yeah? Mike Suzek, who works at Joystick, says that he actually played Secret Ponchos at PAX and at E3 last year, and he really liked the console version. Can you give us a sort of idea of how the development on the console version has gone and how close that is to the PC version and the update process on the console version versus the PC version? Because clearly you guys hit an update today. How easy is it going to be on console?
On console, it's a little tougher to update stuff because they have a lot of quality control, which is good for the end customers, but it means you have to send your stuff through certification and their QA lab will test the game and all that stuff. Whereas Steam, they don't care. Like, you just can update your game every day and it's just your problem if it doesn't work. So I think for us, iterating stuff on Steam is really helpful, and then you know, so we're trying. That's why we're in early access. Is one benefit is we can like polish the game as much as we can with rapid iteration using Steam, and then also at the end we get a PC version out of it. But the console development has a lot of benefits too. Like, it's just so nice that everyone has the same video card. You don't have to worry about like, we get so many support tickets of like, oh, I have this configuration of PC and it doesn't work, you know, and we never had to deal with that in the console world before. So there's pros and cons both ways. It's really fun though, making your game and having people playing it every day. That's crazy. Like it, for us, when we first launched in early access, when we actually got to play with people that weren't us, it was pretty exciting.
No, not what I want to do. No, stop.
What have you done?
All right, got the last one invited.
No, stop. Stop. No, I told it to join a match. I'm trying to make it stop and it won't stop.
Oh, it's okay. Just quit your match.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Rude, quitting a match.
Okay, so what do I do?
Somebody penalize Alexander.
Poor etiquette.
Alexander, hit shift and tab.
Shift, tab.
And you should have a pop-up from Yusuf inviting you to a game. Click that.
Okay,
click on it, please. And join us.
Alexander, you had one job.
The tables are turned.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Do you not know how to internet?
No, I don't know how to Steam. Seriously, Steam and Steam. Friends, stop it.
Hey, Friends is a great show.
Why is Friends not on Steam? I would, like, just buy every episode.
Okay, sale! Chandler edition.
I accepted. Am I not in there?
I'll send you another one just in case.
Oh my god.
Yeah, no,
Yusuf, I have another question for you really quickly. I saw, you know, the instructions on all the controls for secret ponchos. And, it feels very natural as soon as you start picking it up. Like, I picked up on what I needed to do to use my weapons and everything immediately. But I also saw that, like, you have the PlayStation 4 control layout right in there. I have not been able to figure out how to effectively use my DualShock 4 with my PC. How do you go about doing that?
I think it's supposed to be just plug and play. Like, you should just stick
it's
it
plug
in.
Plug and play?
Yeah. You might have some, like, PC issue, like, that's a conflict or something. Because I've heard of it a couple times. Like, a few of our users have had that problem, but generally, like, we've plugged tons of PS4 controllers into PCs, and generally they're plug and play, so...
That's awesome!
Yeah, and it's so nice because you can just use the same controllers on your console and your...
Alright, is this Team Joystick versus...
Yeah,
this is Team
Joystick.
Developers?
This is a massive.
Okay, so we can expect a
massive. Buddy, let's take the lead! It's you and me, baby! Here.
Someone plug in a Game Genie, quick.
Oh, whip!
Attack's going. That is cool how the whip just trails behind your character.
That is super cool. Ooh, yeah, I had no stamina.
I think we were probably a lot easier than it was, but then once we were, like, you know, deep in it, we couldn't turn back. So, let's get going.
Use my curiosity! Oh man, somebody just... Wait! Was that my team who was shooting? Oh my god!
Trying to do this thing. Do it! Oh,
Yusuf.
Remember to take cover.
Oh.
Totally good. I was trying to be fancy.
What was that?
Let me alone. I'm reloading.
I should join your guys' team next time.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I'm going into this tavern for a drink. There's someone behind you. Is it a bad idea throwing dynamite in here? Probably.
Yeah. There's friendly fire? Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's everything.
Ouch.
Oh, it takes so long to reload. I demand more futuristic weapons.
Hey, Luddy, push the door.
Yes.
I can get them on the outside when they come out. Hey, oh.
Oh no! Man. I think it's too late.
It's over.
It's too late.
It's over.
I was gonna try and pull a Django Unchained.
We were washed up. We were hung out to dry, which is proper cleaning technique for ponchos.
Oh no!
I actually have no idea if that's probably... That could ruin a poncho. Don't follow my instructions.
Did I kill 5 people? Is that what that means?
Hey, let's see how you guys did. Whoa.
Oh, man.
Whoa. I just... got 2 kills.
No. I killed
right, 1%.
It just showed the, like, a close-up of the bar scene and the NPC, like, dead NPCs, and some of their faces are just harrowing.
Yeah.
They are...
I've managed to lower the value of
my
head,
watch that movie,
which is what happened when I got a bad haircut.
Yeah, of course.
You know the saloon scene where there's like his friend is like hanging dead in the coffin. There's like dead bodies everywhere, and it's really creepy torches. That's sort of like one of the influences we had for that level.
Cool.
Yeah, the scene right at the end. I'm gonna come out now.
Yeah.
Take a shot at me. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill your family. All their friends. And all their friends! Alright, yeah, Yusuf. Name-dropping Unforgiven when you're making a multiplayer Western shooter, that is a good sign, my friend.
That is the way into Anthony's heart. Obscure old references.
How is Unforgiven?
Unforgiven's not an obscure...
It's a way into
that's
his dad
really
heart.
Obscure.
Academy Award!
It's an That's
come. Oh, did I say old?
You did.
Oh,
I'm pretty sure.
Did I?
Curse. I think it was implied.
Oh, Van River.
What is happening? When Alexander gets bored, he just starts singing.
This is why we keep him entertained at all times.
So, alright, I just got the message. My head is now worth $356. Yusuf, what does that mean?
So that's the bounty. Like, every, there's a value, a persistent value on your character. So, like, when you win matches, the price on your head goes up, and when you lose matches, it goes down. So, basically, it's like the Wild West. Everyone sort of has a different price on their head, a bounty on their head. So you want that number to keep going up. As you, if you do really bad in fights and you lose, you'll see it dropping until you're not worth anything anymore.
What's the bounty on your head right now?
Oh, it's bad because we test the game a lot, so we're like, oh, can you kill me 18 times so we could, like, test this bug?
I'm hearing excuses, but
I know,
what's
the
like,
number?
It sounds like you guys are just achievement hunting and not actually doing a lot of work.
Well, it's head hunting, I think.
All right, so let's see how...
So we need another invite.
I think, you know what, the community has, they're crazy, like, how fast they leveled up. Some of the guys were Deathbringers, like, in 2 weeks, and we thought it would take, like, 3 months for that to happen. So now we have to figure out if we gotta raise all the requirements, or if that's okay, because those guys are just so good.
Alright,
so, did anyone not get an invite yet?
I have not gotten an invite yet.
What was your Steam name again?
Mr. Oh, yeah.
I need another invite to Slyzander.
Okay. Slyzander is true.
We're so needy.
Yusuf, a little question from Wraithdub, rather, here in the chat. Now, obviously, you were saying your marquee release for this is going to be PlayStation 4. Are you going to be doing other platforms? There may be an Xbox.
No, you know what? I think we're just going to stick to PC and PS4 because it's kind of a quality versus money thing. So I think if we released on lots of platforms, we would make more money, but it would just spread our team really thin. Like, we'd have to, you know, support another community and do two sets of matchmaking and two sets of trophies and all that kind of stuff. And I think we would rather just focus all our manpower on just PS4 on the console. And then if it does super good, then and we get some money or something, then we could expand and do that. But I think right now we're just really careful not to take on too much.
But smart. I mean, it seems to me that that's a factor that people forget about. They're like, oh, well, I want this on as many different things in the world. Give me an iPad version. Give me a Vita version. Give me a Neo Geo Pocket version. But every single time you...
You left out one.
Oh, my bad, buddy. Every single time you put a game on a new platform, that's a whole different world of work and support you need to do. Like, you know, what else do you... You know, feel like, you know, obviously you guys aren't a huge team. What do you have to think about that most of your players don't think that you need to think about when you're making a game like this?
I think, you know, it's hard to know how good everyone's going to be in the game, you know, and how quickly, like, what we learned right away was there's such a, there's a huge range in learning curve. So in early access, some people got good really quick, and they just started murdering any new player. And it was just like a murder fest. And so if someone new picked up the game, and we had to sort of think on the adapt really quickly to that, and like, okay, let's make a casual mode, and, you know, that kind of stuff. But I think also, even with DLC, I think that's like a really interesting topic, because some games really are too aggressive with DLC, right? So they monetize everything, and that kind of gave the word DLC a bad feeling. But I mean, for us, DLC just means we get to expand the game after it's done. Like, we can keep adding new characters and stuff like that. So for us, we're actually really excited about it because we just see them as little expansions, right? Like, if we, so I don't know. We're super pumped, but I mean, we're careful now to keep the word expansion. Like, we're gonna expand the character roster instead of saying we're gonna have DLC, because it sort of has another meaning to people.
Yeah, it's funny. I was just gonna say, it seems like a language issue more than anything else. Because, like, DLC sounds like, oh, well, it's gonna be a separate product. But if you say update, people think, oh, well, it's part of an evolving game.
Yeah, like, I bought Diablo, and then, you know, like, 2 months later, or whatever, it was a 2 pack, and I was super excited. excited to pay $50. That, I guess that was DLC back then. It just didn't download if you went to the store. But, you know, back then it wasn't really perceived that, right? It was more like monetizing little trivial things and stuff.
Right.
I hate crates!
Yusef, you mentioned not trying to spread the leak. What about working with Sony and getting the game on PlayStation? Is that something that Sony supports independent developers with, or is it just the virtue of, like, yeah, if you have your game and you want to put it on this platform, you can do it, but you can actually help the support you get that done?
Yeah, they're really helpful because, well, in our case, we didn't have any money for dev kits or anything like that, and they actually just, you know, lend us dev kits to make it happen. But we needed a lot because we were doing like all this deep player stuff, you know. There's that, and there's also just like, you know, if I have a problem about launching on something, I just like call, and there's like an account manager that I have, and they'll talk to you on the phone and stuff. So it's been really refreshing. Because we don't know what we're, like, this is our studio's first game launching as a studio, so there's a lot of stuff that we get help from them on. Like, even, like, stuff like localization, now we're gonna have to, like, add all the languages and stuff to our game, we have no idea what we're doing for that yet, so hopefully they'll guide us a little bit through it.
Can I point out that Team Joystick held out a whole lot longer that time?
Hey, I was not on Team Joystick.
Nobody point out that we lost anyway. Just let's point out that one thing and then
let's
stop.
Let's also point out that we were backed up by a member of Switchblade Monkeys. Whoever is Casper from Switchblade.
Wait, hold up. Wait. I'm the guy with 4 kills and 2 deaths.
I wasn't saying he was the MVP, Alexander.
It's a team game, Alexander.
Yeah, no, you're forgetting there's an I in team.
Yeah, you wouldn't have gotten those 4 kills if Luddy and I haven't given you all our moral support.
Well, while we all lick our wounds,
While
we all lick our wounds here, why don't we take a 30-second commercial break? If you're a Turbo user, you'll stick with us, but we'll be back in 30 seconds if you're not.
You're nothing but meat shields to me.
If I had a nickel for every single time I'd heard that. Yeah, wow, Alexander, your accuracy was really, really good, too. What was the secret, man?
It's probably because you only fired a few shots.
4 kills, 2 deaths.
I think some of my dynamite helped bring down some of the...
Batting 500, folks.
Did you guys try teaming up and just being like, let's two of us stick together or anything? Or are you just running around everybody on their own?
If there's one thing that I can say about Team Joystick is that cooperation is not...
I've never had team building exercises, really. Yeah.
So you know at your studio when you do the trust fall and, like, you catch each other?
We've all broken legs, yeah.
Yeah, we stopped doing that.
There's no I in team, but there's one in Joystick.
With us, it's more like a trust push. There's someone who pushes you down, and there's just no one behind you.
HR.gif.
So there's something there to break your fall, don't get me wrong. It might be a piece of broken glass or an axe.
Shiv.
An axe?
Shake.
it may very well be in, like, an empty beer bottle that is, like, broken at the top, but...
You're all
awful. But you won't fall. It may be a soft bed of strawberry cans.
Yeah.
But.
And they just crumple as you fall on them.
Did anybody not get an invite for the next one?
Me.
I am on my way.
I got
joining
invite.
Up.
Okay, who didn't get it?
Slyzander.
Oh, I never get you.
Nope. Always tried, mate.
Does anyone really get Alexander?
You know what we learned from Early Access? That we really need to make this thing remember who your friends were the last match.
That would be cool. Yeah.
Remember that's, your friends is good.
Have I not
remember
joined
your
the lobby?
Is better.
Yeah, just auto-populate the lobby with your buddies.
So is this...
Can you invite me again, please? I apologize. Yeah. It doesn't appear that I'm in.
Oh, okay, who needs another...
See in the bells, please.
Okay. So how are you guys doing? Do you understand all the moves and stuff?
Yeah, it is very strange to pick up when you very first start, you have to sit there and think about what you're doing. Because I don't know about you guys, and Jess, since you're playing with a keyboard and mouse, is a different experience for you. Mm-hmm. But when I pick something up, and I know I'm using a gun, and I have that overhead perspective, I automatically start to try and to go into, like, Geometry Wars mode.
Yeah, like, there's this muscle memory of omnidirectional shooters that you just want to fly around and shoot everywhere, but I'm trying to force myself to take
care of it. Yeah, totally.
I'm also doing really good at switching from shotgun to whip. Now, my question to you is, when the person goes down to zero health and they're, like, unconscious or whatever that is there a finishing move I'm supposed to do there, or are they just hanging out?
No, they're dead and they're just hanging out. They're just waiting to respawn.
Okay.
Yeah, so we actually have different modes in the game. I should probably talk about this when we get on back on, but the deathmatch mode, when your teammates die, they're just dead for the rest of the round. And so those rounds go pretty quick because everyone just has one death. I really like that mode. That's going to be a mode that we're adding also in the major update. This mode is domination mode, so you respawn. So it's not so bad if you die because you can come back, you know? So it's a little bit more frantic, but, you know, when you can respawn, it changes the way that you play because you're not as careful, you know, you're just a little more crazy. But when you don't respawn, every bullet matters, and if someone on your team dies, you're like, oh man, that idiot, now we have to, you know, do a 2-on-4 or something.
Yeah, I would imagine that makes a really tense match,
guys.
That probably will make you love cover a lot more than you do otherwise.
I hate to interrupt, but unfortunately when I'm trying to join the match, it says joining lobby, and then it lingers for a second and then stops, and then I'm just back in the menu with no one.
Okay, and is that C?
That's C and the bells.
Okay, I'll try to invite you again. Let me try and invite you again.
All right.
I'm gonna invite you too, because I could do that.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks.
Oh yeah, you guys can invite each other too. Actually,
I invited
you. Fast. Is it? Oh wait, no, that would be bad.
Joining lobby session.
Okay.
Connecting. There we go. Now it works.
Wow.
All right, now it's full joystick versus Switchblade Monkeys again.
Except start it? Where do you want to wait? Shit.
Yeah, let's fire it up. Let's get shooting. Alexander, you, me, let's go whip people.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just like E3, all of them.
Do your friends win anything if you guys win or lose?
Yeah, they get a tax break on the next year.
That's right.
When they're doing their 1099s, they get a 5% discount. You know, just like real sports teams, you know? When the Patriots win, we get a discount on our taxes.
See those coffins behind us? We're probably going to be filling them.
Yay!
Not to bring anyone down or anything. This is the Wild West. This is how it goes.
At this level, a lot of the cover objects are destructible too. So if there's even cover and someone's shooting at it, you're gonna see pieces of tombstones flying over.
It's that poor craftsmanship going on in the Wild West. I'm just gonna throw a stick of dynamite wildly, hide over here.
Oh, like I was probably one guy in all those comments.
You should make that guy
as
the DLC character.
I feel like hiding behind a tombstone.
God, I love.
How would you play with the shovel?
Oh, you can do some damage with the shovel.
Like what Ace Spacey does.
We'll make that guy. He hits you with a shovel and.
Oh, the shoveler. It. That was a Mystery Men joke that I almost missed.
that was for you, Zeth. Yusuf, so.
Got a poncho over here. He killed me.
We were going to be checking out a different character, a different class, the Matador, but unfortunately it wasn't quite ready. Can you give us a little like preview of what the Matador is like?
She's really cool because she doesn't fight with the Matador, and all these guys are gunfighters, so we had to figure out how would a Matador fight a gunslinger, and so she has her. We just figured, we looked at bullfighting, we're like, let's just do it the same way that they do it. That the first act, you throw the spears in and you kind of weaken the person. And then once the person's weak, the bull, then they move in for the kill, the execution moves in the third act. So that's what we set up. We were like, okay, so she's really weak if you go head to head. But if she can get a spear in you, then you move slower and you're weakened. And then if you get another spear in you, you're really vulnerable. So that's her job, is to like spear you twice and then goes to the execution. And so you want to kind of gun her down before she can do that. But she's naturally very evasive, like a matador. And she has a cape, and she can, like, pick up dust with her cape and blind you, so then you don't know where she is. And then she can, like, sneak up behind you again.
That sounds...
That sounds awesome.
Yeah, it sounds so finessey and cool.
Yeah.
I was gonna ask about lady characters.
Oh, she's the coolest lady character, because we really didn't want to put, I don't know, you know, the classic MOBA...
Throwing a stick of dynamite, watch out.
MOBA lady characters, where they're just...
Right. Oh, God!
Interesting about them is that they're pretty. We wanted to make her... So we kind of thought, how do we design girl characters? So it's... I don't know, how do we... What's our philosophy for it? And we just thought, well, they shouldn't be cool because they're pretty. She should be cool because she's just cool. Like, if she was a
Sit
guy,
down! Sorry.
No, that trash talk was well earned.
Jess, we got this guy.
I think, I had to bow out there. I was getting low. I'm sorry, I'm coming for you.
I got put down.
Run away. Love and peace. Love and peace.
Oh.
I think my next upgrade will be speed. This guy is large and slow.
I'm going to mix you guys up with a couple of these Switchblade Monkeys guys. They're not taking it easy on you.
That's fine. Thank you.
We don't need no pity, Yusuf.
Did you just pity us?
There's going to be some firings in the studio after this.
Zero kills, five
Wait, so let's just focus on who had zero kills.
They probably didn't have this at E3. The way that you're supposed to demo this for press is every time we kill something, or even if we move slightly, you're supposed to say, oh, no one's ever done that before. You're so good at this game.
Yeah, you're supposed to make us feel good. Even if we demonstrate the most basic of aptitude in playing any kind of video game. Oh, you moved the character. That's great. You're the first one to do that.
You know, like, part of someone having a good time in the game is they feel that they're good at it, right? And so when we were at PAX, our game showed it was just chaos, because everyone kind of carefully builds a demo and takes them through the perfect experience of scripted experience. But for us, we just threw 8 people in a match on the floor and let them fight. And that was the press's first impression of the game, because we didn't really know any better. That's just all we, you know, how we thought you'd do things. And it was brutal, because some of the kids at PAX are like the most hardcore gamers in the world. And then I remember doing an interview, and they're just like killing my press over and over. And then she was like, this game is too hard. I was like, oh.
Yeah, so I was one of those people, and in kindness, I played it for like 60 seconds. I'm like, yep, no, I'm done, because all I did was just like walk on the field, die, walk on the field, die. I'm like, nope, can't do this. Sorry, I'm so doing much better this time around, though.
Yeah,
my awesome guy, my bounty has gone down to 0.
Aww.
I am far from being able to upgrade my character.
Well, you were 0-5 last game.
I was 0-5 last game. That's true.
So really,
I was full of assists, though, Jess.
I know, full and there is no assist counter.
Oh, assist! That's horrible. That must be a Western affliction.
So, Yusuf, straight up, this needs a rematch button.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's what we're definitely missing here. Just to go straight in.
Look, everyone, we're doing our job. We're providing feedback.
No one's ever done that before. You're the first person today to do that.
Well, we better do that now while it's in early access. Otherwise, it's going to be on the reviews.
Exactly.
This is a fact.
Very true. You know how it works.
We already have the review all written up.
Just tell me, just write up the review and tell me all the bad stuff, and then we'll fix it in early access.
Is that how this works? Oh, man.
Yes, can you toss me an invite, please?
Sure. Said that? See you in bells?
See you in bells.
All right.
Honest to God, maybe that's what our early access review policy should be. It should be just like lines of text, and then whatever is there when the game actually comes out, we leave there, and what isn't, we just delete it out of the review.
Hey, give them a point. Give them a point for fixing it.
This game doesn't seem historically accurate, so that's minus a star. I don't seem to recall people coming back to life every time they died.
Somebody didn't watch very much Deadwood, Ludwig.
The poncho physics aren't entirely
realistic. Who needs it? Who's Lil Kip?
While you guys are setting up your next match, why don't we take a quick 30-second break, all right?
Yeah.
All right.
Right back. If you're a Turbo user, you'll be right with us.
Good day, Turbo user.
You're Nobody the insult best. The Turbo users.
The best in the world. I'm gonna sing and dance for you.
So did you guys all get invites?
No. We're waiting for Alexander, but I am inviting him.
I didn't
get
an invite.
Who's I just Lil invited Kip? Alexander.
You know why we didn't really have think about the rematch button? Is this the first time we're playing 4-on-4? And usually when it's like 2-on-2, it's really fast to invite your friends, but
right.
It's brutal and there's 8 people.
I didn't get a rematch. I didn't get an invite, Yusuf.
Alexander, I just sent
it's
you.
Thomas. Oh.
I don't want an invite from you.
That's sly, right?
Yeah.
Oh, God,
that invite is tempting.
Alexander.
Always forgotten. No one remembers me.
Alexander. But do you love me?
But do you love me? I simply cannot do it alone.
What is going on?
So, Yusuf, are there going to be different times for the matches? Because these are all pretty rapid fire, like what, 3 minutes or something we're playing each time?
Yeah, there's different modes. So this mode, it's either 3 minutes or it's the first team that gets 5 kills in a row. The other modes, like deathmatch and stuff, they just pretty much play until everyone on one team is dead, and that's round one. And then it plays like Street Fighter, where you win the best 2 out of 3 rounds.
Oh, that's cool.
But I don't know. That's something we're looking at. Like the free for all matches. We're trying to figure it out. Like, they feel a little bit fast to me, you know?
Yeah,
Like, I don't know, what do you think? Would you rather see these rounds go longer?
I would, yeah.
Yeah, I'm with you, Jess. I would like, there are moments, I can see how once you've really, really gotten a handle on your character class, and you feel good working with a team, that you can hop into this, and the speed of it will feel very satisfying, like a Street Fighter match. For somebody that's just diving in, it's over so quickly that it's hard to start to get a keen sense of what's happening.
Yeah. Right, so maybe casual mode, all the rounds should just be longer.
Never use the word casual.
Yeah.
That's true.
There's my pro tip for you. Don't use the word casual.
Your audience does not like that. They react.
They will not react well to the words casual, and they will not react well to the words accessible. Do
or
not use
social.
Those.
Don't ever use the word social.
Yeah. Social, accessible, and casual. Do not use those three words.
What about baby outlaw mode?
Yes! Yes! That's perfect!
And
have
all
fun with it.
Yeah.
Oh
as long
God,
as they're all
awesome.
Tiny character models.
Yes.
And every time they die, they just start crying.
This is designing a sequel right now.
Got a kid on kid battle going on here. Don't run away from me. Come here, little fat.
Oh my God.
Oh.
Okay, so you mixed up teams.
Alexander, I will avenge you. Here, let's pincer.
Ow! Oh, I had dynamite in my pocket.
Or were you just happy to see someone?
Oh my God.
I might have.
Even the developer is like, oh.
Stop shooting me. I'm just a kid. I'm a child. Poor child. My parents are dead. You can't do this.
Deserter in this match. The big blue guy.
I am a big blue guy.
I took on three. I took on 2 red deserters at the same time. And I was.
Yeah, I'm a deserter. Right?
Oh, you are?
Okay, yeah.
So if you press the evade button. You'll do it like you check and it'll actually stun someone and knock them down.
Yes, I did that once, it was awesome. I gotta do it again.
So that's a good move if you need space, you know, if you want to get rid of somebody.
Yeah.
And then another move you can do with deserter is you're playing on a keyboard and mouse, right?
I am, unfortunately.
Okay, do you have a middle mouse button?
Yeah, and I've been scrolling between my weapons and I just healed myself. So that was good.
So with your goal, if you hold down the middle mouse button, you'll see the deserter will take a knee and he'll do like a snipe shot. And then you can do a really long range snipe shot when you...
Oh! I gotta try that. Alright, okay.
Alright, we have a minute. We can still turn this around.
Yeah,
it's even.
Luddy, let's see if you can get a dynamite, stick some dynamite in someone's pocket.
I would rather not.
Oh, someone got me with dynamite in my pocket. Ugh. Only thing you can do in that situation is run at the enemies. Screaming. Pull them all up.
Ah! We're watching the wrong person.
Alright, come on, we're teaming up here. We're teaming up.
We are?
Okay, oh, I just got bayoneted really bad by Julian.
That's what I want to do. I want to bayonet someone.
No! That
kill it. Oh
no.
My goodness.
Nope, okay. Keyboard, that does not work
right.
Very well.
You got him. Leave me alone. Oh man.
Sorry, man. Try to avenge you. Oh.
Well, we almost got it.
See, avenging is a bad idea because that just gets
okay,
you into
so
more
if
trouble.
If it's a tie, nobody die, and then if it's a tie, we're gonna go into front of death.
Yeah. Nobody die.
Oh no! Someone got a kill.
Nobody die!
Wait, that's dynamite. That was dynamite on me.
Oh.
Oh, massacre.
I did not do well that game. I'm trying to be too fancy.
Alexander, that was a beautiful, beautiful little double skeleton action there at the end. You're just victorious.
What? Wait, what?
Did you guys win a round?
We won? Oh, no.
Nine kills from the member of Switchblade Monkeys.
with 77% accuracy.
Hey, to be clear, I had 63%, so I only had 14% less.
I did not.
My head is worth $64. I could buy my own head at this point.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so now how do I change my character?
Oh, just go to Outlaw.
In the menu, yeah.
In the lobby, yeah.
My head is worth 403, so I think I'm doing okay.
Oh, nice. If you get 1,000, you're going to get a level up.
Hey.
My head is worth 150 an hour.
Hey.
Right, I'm going to try and
family show.
$0. Oh, that's another interesting question, Yusuf. I find that you go into most games, and even failure these days is met with some level of experience or upgrading. But I have just beefed it these last two rounds. I have done terribly, and I am down at zero. Do you worry? Do you worry that like some people will be turned off if they're like really really bad, but they keep throwing themselves at the game that they make no progress?
Yeah, you know, it's always scary when you do something slightly different. Like we really wanted to reward you based on your performance and not just based on farming, you know, but I think we need to put some kind of buffer so that new players they can get a little bit of momentum. But I do think that I really like the idea that, I mean, how we set up is even if your team loses, if you carried your team and say you got like 6 kills and your team didn't do anything, you're still going to come out of there with your bounty and your head higher.
Yeah.
So, and if your team wins and you just sucked, then you're still going to lose some bounty. So I think that aspect is cool, but we maybe swung a little bit too far, and we gotta...
See, I personally like that it is so hard on you.
Yeah?
It doesn't turn me off at all. It's like, well, if I get to zero, I gotta play more, because I can't go any further down than zero, right?
Right.
So then you get to zero, then you gotta play more, and then your bounty will start going up again. I'm okay with that.
Hey, Yusuf?
Alexander, accept my invite.
I did. Yusuf, if I've got main thread time averaging something and render thread time and GPU time showing up at the bottom of my screen, what buttons did I accidentally hit?
Shift P somehow you hit.
Shift P.
Listen, I named myself after an accounting package, so that's completely non-threatening. So... there's really no need to attack me.
So something we do on Early Access that might be a little different than other developers is we set up daily playtimes. And so every day the development team will just log into Steam and we'll play it at 3 p.m. and 8 p.m. Pacific time. Okay. And we also join the group chat. So then any of our community, they can just play with us and chat with us and stuff. And it's been a lot of fun. We've got a lot of good feedback that way. So if anyone's interested in on the Early Access and just wants to give us feedback, or if you're already playing, make sure to jump on those times and join the group chat and be on there.
Oh God!
That was my gravestone. I mean, it wasn't mine because I'm alive, but I was using it to take cover, so I claimed it. It was mine.
Oh, snap, son, in the back. That's you.
This violence against the elderly will not stand.
This will probably be the last round.
Blue team, let's all join up at the top section, and we'll, I guess I'm going to keep, like, on my team, let's try and just group up together.
I'm trying to snipe you! Group mid, group mid! Yeah!
Wrong game, Jess, wrong game.
Sorry, okay, sorry.
Group mid!
Everyone go all random. All middle, let's do it.
Where is the rocket launcher?
Someone back door.
Power weapons in the library. No way.
That is awesome.
Are you playing Clue?
He's playing Clue.
You're mixing.
Colonel Mustard is our new DLC guy.
Yeah! Professor Plum with the whip.
Come on. Don't fail me now.
How's that Quicken name working out for you, buddy?
Not very well. More like Quicken the Dead.
Oh!
You didn't see the horn on that. Okay.
That's right, I set up a name just to make that.
You didn't see that coming.
I'm not above that. Listen, could you just. I'm just trying to reload over here. Goodbye.
I see people, so consider it. I'm trying to reload, guys.
That's me.
I like that the progress bar above is it goes through the skull's eyes.
Oh, come here.
Oh no.
Yes! Yes!
Ouch! Oh man. Oh. Fuck.
I threw a knife at you, that should be enough. Oop. Oh, hello.
Ludwig, I think I am hunting you. Like,
have you tried
gun down.
Not doing that?
Yeah, I hate Quicken.
I would like to
if
kill
you
one
guy.
You know what I think we should do if there. I don't know if there's time, but if we go back to you guys versus us for one last round, you can see how you progress.
Let's do it.
All right, we'll do it.
I can't get out of this.
We hereby agree to imminent humiliation.
Ouch! It hurts.
You could still be fine. Maybe you're just taking it.
Do you guys find that you're getting better at the game or learning sort of the intricacies of playing it while you're sort of learning at the same time here?
Yeah, you know, like, I feel, especially, like, at the beginning, I was just sort of going crazy. I was going out there like a berserker. And at this point, over the past couple of rounds, I've gotten a much better sense of the rhythm of using Phantom Poncho. Because that character, you've got to use the whip, then the shotgun. Use the whip, then the shotgun. And you can't, like, just rely on one or the other. You've got to be able to really get a feel for the rhythm. But, I, you know, I'm sure that all the characters have that.
With Phantom Poncho, do you ever use the L bumper?
No.
Because if you use that, you can actually aim, and he'll do this little dash where, while you're aiming, he can, like, strafe. So he can, like, strafe to the left, take a shot, strafe back.
Oh, well.
See, but now you're going to try it. Because that's what I've been trying to do, the fancy sniping move this whole time, and it's just decimated my quality.
Well, it's 4:58 right now here on the East Coast, which means we're just a couple of minutes away from the end of the stream, but I think we have time for one more round, right?
All right, I'll get you guys in here fast.
Woo-hoo.
And we are plumb out of codes, too, so this is all for pride at this point. People are watching Joystick, and they're going to be focused on the match and not on the chat.
Yeah!
Okay.
No this pressure.
Let's hear it, guys. Go Team Joystick.
This is for reals, guys. The best in the universe.
best in the universe all over the place. Next time. Lil Kip is a ferocious competitor, I'll tell you that much.
Yeah. Who is that?
Sly, did you get an invite this time?
Oh, let's see.
I still need one over here for
Mr.
Gucci.
Okay, Mr. Gucci, okay.
Yep.
Mr. Ganucci.
Anthony, something Mimic in chat says there's 2 minutes left, so they need you to do a dad joke.
Oh, God. Man, I haven't seen a cowboy this wild since Will Smith insulted Kenneth Branagh's beard?
What?
Is that...
Are you referring to the Wild Wild West?
I am. Okay. Was that dad enough?
Maybe. Wild
is.
Maybe. Possibly.
You know, I could imagine my father thinking that's a new movie because he saw it on ABC Family Night or something. So I will accept that as a potential dad joke.
Something Mimic, please let me know if you approve of the dadness. I think a dad joke needs to be at, like, a cultural touchstone that's at least 20 years old. And, you know, Wild Wild West is only 15, so... Alright, well, next round I'll say something about Jamiroquai, I don't know.
And people in chat are extremely confused, which is the touchstone of a dad joke.
Yeah, that's good.
So I think you nailed it. A lot of what's, a lot of fails, you know, general feeling of the dad thing.
Look at that knife.
Got your own dynamite, dude. How's that feel?
Oh, I got quit to death by Casper.
Casper's so good, stop it.
Not a friendly ghost.
That was good, yeah.
Don't think I'm getting up from that again.
Reload! I forget to reload all the time.
Oh my god.
Oh gosh!
Man, buddy, you got shucked so hard that your cat came off.
Yeah. You guys should have taped it down. Oh,
my god,
I got someone.
Closing the gap, yes.
Have a knife that I threw in a random direction.
Someone might step on it and injure themselves, so.
No.
Oh.
Yeah!
Nice. Sneaky.
Come back here, you stupid little redheaded accident!
Oh, man. No, he got me!
Seems like, Anthony, that you've reminded people of a movie they tried to forget, because there's a lot of chat about Wild Wild West.
Hey, I like that.
The worst thing.
That movie was terrible.
Great.
Yes, knife in the back.
So everybody,
I'm going to take credit for it anyway.
Promotion on the 5th, so I can't really say what the promotion will be, but it's going to be our new content and stuff, and it'll be like a discount. Yeah. So if everyone, we're trying to really build momentum on that date, so if anyone wants to pick up the game, I would recommend August 5th.
That in the chat before ending today. Oh man, we've got 40 seconds left, and it's not looking good. Everybody, thank you for coming out today for Joystick Streams, Joystick Poncho Time. our secretive ponchos. Actually, I think if Joystick made this game, it would be called Obvious Ponchos, because we are not excellent.
Bullet-riddled ponchos.
Bullet-ridden ponchos. He and Jess had a nice zero kill ratio there.
Hey, I got four kills, balanced out with four deaths.
But, Yusuf, thank you so much for coming out, and, this was, I want to keep playing. I want to get better. I would like an actual bounty on my head. Thank you.
That was fun.
No problem, guys. Thanks for having us. It was fun playing with you.
Good. And everybody, you can check out Secret Ponchos on Early Access right now. There's a big update, as Yusuf was just saying, on August 5th. Tons of new content. And it'll be out later this year on PlayStation 4, right?
Yeah, PlayStation 4 is going to make its big console debut in the fall.
As for us, we will be back on Thursday at 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and Ludwig and I are going to be checking out 1001 Spikes, so if you didn't see us dying enough today, well, you're in for a treat then.
Oh man, how am I going to train myself not to say horrible things?
You just take Alexander's School of Bum Bum guide to...
Can we just introduce a delay for someone else to peep over anything that I say?
And you know what, guys? There's always the possibility that we might stream something between now and then. So if you want to find out when we do things that are unscheduled, Why don't you just follow us there on Twitch? Just give us a little follow.
We may have people in the chat come up with a word that you have to say that when you want to say the fudge word or the bum bum word.
That's a great idea.
Like they'll come up with words that you have to say when you just are going expletive extreme.
I love it. I love chat voted expletives. That's what we bring here on Joystick Streams and joystick.com. We specialize in that kind of fun.
Twitch plays expletives.
Yeah. So yeah, guys, we will see you on Thursday. Definitely, we may see you sooner. Maybe.
Go ahead and hit that follow button there on the left side of your screen, and you'll know when we're frickin' back with some bum bum scratching awesomeness.
And yeah, follow us on Twitch. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook. And Google+, just search for Joystick with a Q. And we'll see you next time, guys. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.